There is another lab of WDS that is very important, which is zero touch. And normally I didn't used to do that before, but after one student said, okay, in the interview, I was asked that, how to do zero touch, and I could not answer that. Then I thought, okay, let's just add that too, zero touch installation. So let me explain how does it work. We still have on the server side, we don't have to do anything now. I mean, like anything new. Everyone got that email to download WD, download ADK.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah.
And every day, everyone downloaded. I sent that email to the group. So, in that, I sent a Dropbox link to download ADK file. That is 3 GB file, right? So if you did not download, just give USB to your, you know, class fellow and get that file. So Mr. Shahid, you downloaded that file?
Yeah.
So you can get from him the USB file?
I just
didn't download. Okay. Then it's okay, doesn't it? What? So you did not download?
Yes.
Okay, so you can take from him from on USB. So we can do it now. This is, if it was not that important in the interview, we could have just skipped it, but it is important for interview. So let me just show you what's that you know, plan for that. Here, if we have DC and WDS here, so we're going to create an answer file. Anyone knows already the concept of answer file? So answer file
has all the parameters.
Yes. Good. For what?
They are taken by the remote.
So in the first lab, we just installed a lab and we had to click, right? Next. But answer file does that for us. So this is where you're installing it on 100 computers. 100 computers, right? So then you can use that answer file to deploy it, that operating system, without going there and touching there. As long as the operating system empty machine starts, as long as it starts. So how to create an answer file? It's a tricky business. We have already done so many tricky things till now, but how to use an ADK and how to create an answer file, that's something we need to learn, right? So for that, there is that ADK 3 GB file that you must have in your computer. So let's take a 10-minute break, and while you take a break, let's just make sure that the answer file is copied inside the C drive of your server one. The ADK file is copied inside the C drive of server one, ADK file, right? If you do not have ADK file, sorry?
That was the name as a script. Yeah.
ADK. So let me show you now. Assuming now. So we are copying the ADK file because we want to do the zero touch installation. So we're going to just copy the ADK file, which is nearly 3 GB. We're going to just go and go copy inside the C drive. So I'm going to the server one. It's better to create a folder. So if I go to the C drive of server one, do I already have a software folder here? Nope. So I'm just gonna right click and create a folder called software. Software. And double click. Right click and paste.
Server one?
Yep. Server one inside C drive, I'm creating a new folder called software. And inside the software folder, I am pasting this ADK. Mr. Ola. Everything okay?
I'm just trying to get the ADK.
All right. So if ADK is copied, let me know. So who has ADK copied in the C drive already?
No,
you're done, you're done?
Yeah.
Wow, okay.
Yeah.
So it's not copied in students folder yet. resuming. So on server one, what? So anyone can tell me why are we creating answer file? One liner only.
We don't want to touch.
So the scenario is, if there are 100 computers, even 10 computers, you don't want to go to each computer one by one. So you don't want to click next, 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 right? So that's why it's going to be, hey, that's like you're taking mental note now. So who's there, who's not? That's good.
Okay. Good memory.
Good memory. Okay, that's good. So make sure I'm here. Okay. Okay, so let's just go ahead. I'm just gonna go quickly to Magnifico. Okay. Yes, sir. But PDF is there, and I'm gonna be flipping PDF just to show. And I want to make sure that about from those million steps, I don't forget, because nobody can memorize those million steps. And you will see.
Thank you, my bro.
Okay. So first, let's just go to file yellow folder or the file explorer, and you have this ADK folder. Yes. Double click that. Second thing, ADK setup. Double click that. Anyone there? So I did not double click yet, but you're there. It's a typical simple installation. On the first screen, specify location, which is okay. Don't change anything here. This is the virtual machine where it's installing. Next. Anyone falling behind, let me know. Okay, then. How behind are you?
Just one or two steps.
From beginning?
Yes.
Yeah, so I'm just canceling out. So everyone on this folder, ADK?
Yeah.
Okay, yes. Double click, and then everyone on the exe file?
Yes. Yeah.
Double click.
Okay.
The first screen is this for everyone?
Yes.
Okay, next. We don't want to improve this product, so no. Oh, we want to improve. Just kidding. Next.
Yes.
License agreement, everyone. Accept. And here. So, see this? We do not want all of those, right? We do not want all of those. So, whichever we want, we're going to select those. So, I'm just going to go to that PDF document and go down, down, and downer. So these are three, right? The Lemon Tools, Windows Pre-Installation Environment, PE, and Windows Performance Toolkit. So everyone sees that. So we uncheck.
Two, three, and six. Second last.
Second last.
Six.
Yeah, 2, 3, 6, exactly. So I'm just gonna go there and do that myself. So 2, 3, this one is there. Uncheck, uncheck, uncheck. So no.
Uncheck.
Yeah, uncheck. So, everyone there?
Yeah.
Dude, it done. So, now it comes down to 3.2 gigs in the size, right? Install?
Okay.
Yes. It should go fast.
And then installer?
Yep. You're there?
Installer?
Yeah, double click that.
Yeah.
Next.
Oh, no, no.
ADK, right? Or you want to copy that from there? So copy that into C drive of server one. Oh, it's still going on.
Mine is asking for the admin password.
No.
Inside the virtual machine?
No, on the actual machine.
Yeah. You say no, it will cancel out.
I said no, and the thing generated an error, so that's why I don't want to say no.
Yeah, for in smart. This is inside your server one, right?
Yes, inside the
virtual machine server one.
Oh, sorry.
Should I beat you up or what?
Yeah, I think now we should be serious about this. Or Chukandar.
Yeah.
Just gift him a chukandar.
Bring some chukandar.
Man. But if you had run sysprep on physical machine,
yeah,
it would have just destroyed the whole thing.
Mine is done.
All right.
Welcome to Windows Assessment and
Deployment. What? It's already done. I'm on 60%.
Oh, mine is done too.
Serious?
Yeah.
Done?
Yeah.
All done? It's okay, laptop. They don't mean it. It's okay.
Maybe you didn't pay the last
installment.
Of, oh, hey, how do you know that? I did pay, come on. Best Buy, always they follow up with another collection agency.
Bro, yeah. One question. But the ADK file itself will load it on the C drive or the physical computer, right? I asked you that before I started.
No.
You're not listening to me.
Oh my God.
Yeah, right.
Oh my God. That is good.
He wants to blame somebody.
Thing is to blame these.
I repeated that million times.
Ten times
I repeated that.
I said that you not quickly say I was not in class.
Oh yes. I was gonna say that. Attack is the best defense, right? So you attacked instead of me attacking you. That you're not in the class, buddy. Okay, close that. No, this is a starting guide. We don't need to check this box. So click close. And now we need to see where that software was installed. So we need to go to this Windows starter area. Is it copied, Jeff?
Yeah.
Okay. So once inside, go to this down arrow. Everyone sees the down arrow? And then, what is the new stuff that we downloaded? Let me just show you. Exactly, ADK. So, but which one are we supposed to open? There's a Windows Performance Manager and there's a Windows Performance Recorder. Windows, yeah, this one. So WSIM or Windows System Image Manager. If you go in search and just type Windows System, also, you would find it, Windows System Image Manager.
Can we click on that?
Yep, click on that. So Windows System Image Manager, everyone clicked it?
Yeah.
Okay. Double click or click. So now the whole task starts here. We have to create an answer file and attach it to our basic lab Windows 8, which was working fine. So if it is open, it's gonna look like this.
Yes.
Okay, so is it on for everyone? Yes? Yes. Welcome back.
No, that was second career.
It was not government
No, no, I was welcoming back.
Oh, I see.
So every 10 minutes, I'm gonna welcome him back. So if this is open, let's start configuring it. I'm just gonna take on the PDF file, I'm gonna go to that page on the PDF file. Yes, we opened the WSIM. And there you go. So this is open, WSIM, Windows System Image Manager. Now we're gonna right click here and create a distribution share, but don't do that now. And it should be disk share like this. So this is not in the screenshot, but we're going to create a new folder now by the name of dist-share inside the C drive. Right now, we're going to create a new folder called dist-share inside the C drive. So this one, dist or distribution. So I'm just going to go back to the machine. So one, C drive. C drive of virtual machine,
yeah.
Right click, new folder, dist-share. It could be actually any like distribution or software distribution. It's not like compulsory like just this name, but dist-share or distribution share. So even later when you're going for PDF, you're gonna be able to just follow it up. So dist-share, D-I-S-T. It's not compulsory. This is just something in the PDF, so we're following. So dist, everyone create that?
Yeah.
You don't really have to follow exact spelling. It's not that compulsory, but that's it, right? So dist-share. Now, everyone there?
Yeah.
Everyone create that?
Yeah.
Okay. So let's go back to this file, this one showing here. So never close it. So if the dist-share is created already, so right click. And create distribution share. So we're gonna give the path of that folder that we created. Yes, Ola, which stage are you on?
I finished the installation of that. I did 911.
So create a new folder.
I did that.
Okay, then you're there.
Yeah, I created a new folder.
So that's where we are exactly right now. So create distribution share, and I'm just browsing it to C drive, and then I'm going to disk-share, right? Double click, or we'll just open it, right? Double click open. When you click open on the right side, it's created. Yes,
no,
yes, sir.
Go to C drive, then, open it here.
Then go to the disk-share and click open, and it should look like this. Is it so for everyone?
Yes.
Did it copy?
No, it didn't.
Huh?
I don't have permission to
that. Oh, then create a new folder in C drive in virtual machine. Create a new folder called software, and then copy inside the software. Okay. So disk dash, everyone created that?
No, I created a folder in C drive.
And then you have to right click here.
Okay, one right click here.
And then distribution folder, the bottom option.
Create distribution share.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then go to that C drive and disk share. Browse.
Okay.
And then just click open. Did you click open?
Yeah.
Cannot determine local file type. You might not have permission.
I don't know why it's seeing that.
Oh, no, it's okay. I'm there. Where's your drive? Where's your drive?
It pulled out.
Oh, it's not connecting. The drive is not there.
Passport.
Nope. You have to reconnect again.
Okay.
And so I'm on the PDF folder, guys. And this is where the next part is. Now we are mounting which folder? We're gonna mount the Windows 8 on the DVD of our SOR 1. So mount Windows 8.1 ISO to the DVD of Server 1.
So right click.
Now let's do that.
Okay.
So I'm just gonna go to Server 1. And right click.
Yeah.
So and settings. Sometimes I'm
DVD.
Questioning that Chukandar, you know.
Yeah.
I think you did not have Chukandar. Oh, okay, anyway. Or half of it. You know, you should have had full. Okay, anyway. So so let's just go for DVD here.
Yeah.
And browse.
Yeah.
We already have Windows 2012 mounted. Instead, go to your C drive, go to the ISO folder. You must have the ISO that ends with DV9 or the enterprise in the middle of that line. That's the Windows 8.1. You have to mount the ISO Windows 8.1. Do you see inside this DV9 is exactly whichever? Yeah, double click that, select that DV9 at the end is actually the Windows 8.1 folder.
Okay.
Oh, ISO actually. So DV9 here, do you see that? At the end, so go to C drive, browse.
Option then.
Option mein nahi jana
hai. Hardware.
Hardware.
Are you there?
Yeah, I'm on hardware.
DVD.
Browse. Hardware. Where are you? Oh, hardware then CD, DVD?
Yeah.
Then browse.
Just one here, I'm taking steps.
911, come on.
Yes,
you were about to be promoted, but. Browse.
My own DV9.
I was going to.
Okay. My own DV9 is the Windows Server ISO.
Windows 2012. So yes, go for the.
Yeah.
So no, it should be Windows 8.1. So whichever says enterprise. See this. See the board, everyone.
My friend is making me laugh. There are two DV9s on mine.
So
two DV9s.
So see the board, everyone.
Enterprise.
The line that says enterprise.
Enterprise.
The line that says enterprise.
Okay.
Because we downloaded it directly from the internet, and at home, if you download, you're gonna see this.
But you can rename it. Just give it a shot.
Yes, we can rename it. When we were doing the image, that guy did not rename that. So because it's like this in there. So that's why I'm just. Yeah, so later I'm gonna ask that guy. I'm gonna do that myself to just rename it.
Okay.
Or so enterprise here. Everyone selected that.
Okay.
Double click, and press OK. Okay, this step has been done by everyone.
Yes.
Oh, okay. Thank you. So I'm just gonna go back to the PDF and go down, just showing you where it's not going to, where it's giving gap and where it is perfect. So now we will be going to the Windows image side. Let me just check two of these. So until we see this on this side, so please follow me now. So on server one, is everyone on this one? This answer file. So Windows system, right click this, select Windows image.
Okay.
When you select Windows image like this, everyone did that? Okay. Select Windows image, everyone there? So now, did we mount that Windows 8.1? So go to this PC, go to DVD, D drive.
Yeah, it is already there.
Sources.
Okay.
So you're everyone there?
Yeah.
911 is there as well?
Yeah.
911's. Okay, sources. You are the 911 as well, man. Okay.
Just
drunk with water. Drunk with water. Okay, install.vim. So why not boot.vim? This is a very good question. Because install.vim has the rest of the Windows files whose answers we're going to add in the answer file. When the installation of a typical Windows 8 starts, what happens? It stops at what is the keyboard? What is the language you want to select? What is the license agreement? I mean, license agreement you have to select. Is it a custom or, you know, whatever the answers are. Those questions and answers we're going to create now, those questions come in the install.vim portion. So that's why we need to put install.vim here, because those questions will be coming from install.vim. So we're going to select all those portions and we're going to create an answer file out of that. So install.vim, when you double click, yes, so press yes here.
Yep.
Let's see that.
Sorry.
Oh, cannot.
So click on install.vim and then open, right?
Yeah. Everyone got this?
Yes.
So install.vim, it says cannot read write access, right? Oh, right. So this means that install.vim, we can copy from the DVD inside a new folder and then give the path of that new folder to this area. Yeah, so what will happen, press OK here. It's OK, I mean, press OK here.
Yeah.
Do not close this window until we are finished with this lab. Do not close this window. Now let's go back to the folder again, the yellow folder. Everyone there? Let's go back to the yellow folder.
Okay.
After getting that error, I just pressed OK. Right? There was nothing else to do. So go to this PC. Everyone?
Yes.
Go to DVD. If you double click, I think it's gonna start installation. So right click and open the DVD. Right click and open the DVD. Right click and open the DVD. When you go there, you see the folder list, file lists. Right click and open. Did you right click and open? So sources.
Yeah.
Everyone there? Sources. Now click once anywhere. Click once anywhere in the sources folder. Shall we?
Yes.
In the sources folder. Click once anywhere and go for I. We're looking for install.vim file.
Yeah.
So I.
Okay.
There it is. Install.vim. I think everyone found it.
Yes.
Right click. Install.vim.
Yeah.
Yeah, you want it? Copy. Everyone there? Copy.
Yes.
Okay. Sunny there?
Yeah.
Copy. and then go back to this PC. If you copied it, go back to this PC and go to C drive.
C drive.
Did we create a folder called software already?
Yes.
Exactly. So double click software folder and paste it here. Double click software folder and right click and paste. So what just happened? What happened was that first we gave the path of the DVD. It wanted to get the information from install.vim, that Windows System Image Manager. It wanted to get information from install.vim and then write it somewhere. DVD is only readable. You cannot write on DVD. So then we have to just copy the install.vim on a CD drive, C drive. Here now when we do the same process again, it's going to collect the information again from install.vim, but this time it's going to write it in the same folder, some of the information. And we're gonna see what is the result of writing that information. We're going to see all the options inside. It's gonna be a huge folder that you're gonna see. But it needs to write somewhere after collecting information, and it cannot write in DVD. DVD is just readable, right? So that's why we copied install.vim inside the C drive, so it could write something there as well. Oh, you guys must be done already. Okay. Oh, that was a relief. Oh man, that's why I already asked the management, give me these computers here as well. So I'll be hiding behind this monitor. Or maybe, you know, Adris will just put the monitor, he'll come here and put the monitor here. You know, that was unique. At once, Ola's monitor moved. What happened? So okay. Install.vim is copied, right? But we know the path here, C:\Software. That's the path, right?
Yeah.
Now, if we go to that Windows System Image Manager, please don't close it ever until the lab is going. Now we do the same thing with the new path, which is
right-click,
select Windows Image, this PC,
C drive,
software exactly, software, and install.vim. Now this time it should not give you an error. So double click the install.vim.
Okay, yes.
Press yes. You know, Ola has a tendency to...
No, my mouse is fast.
That's good. Blame on the mouse now. First blame on the teacher, now blame on the mouse. Man, this guy is political. Really? We're gonna vote for you from Scarborough Mayor.
No.
You could be Scarborough Mayor. Double click. So it's gonna collect the information and then it's going to write that information on the C drive. But what is the information it's collecting? Let me show you now while it is going on. When we go there, these two folders should be showing after it is done. Second thing you're gonna see here is all these lines. Now these lines are those areas which normally, some of those areas where the installation stops, and then we have to collect these lines, click these lines, add our own values. It's not gonna be easy, but this is what we need to go through at least once to know how to create an answer file.
So this is answer file being created.
This is those questions that come. We will be creating from there an answer file, which is a separate procedure to create an answer. And we're gonna know now how to do that. So, and here on the right side top is the answer file area. We're gonna create an answer file on the right side. So if we go to the PDF here, this will be the new answer file area that we're creating, right? So if we go back to the, should have done, seriously. No, I think it's not done.
Not done yet.
Oh, okay. God, are you saying that just?
No, right.
What? Did you push it like, you know, just show the, you know, okay. wow, this machine is, you know, when you're gone, so when the new machine comes, I'm going to put the new machine there and get that machine here.
Yes.
That's okay. Serializing the data. Are you all getting this? Serializing? No, oh, this is the actual file. That's a good one. Am I showing the PDF now?
It probably wasn't moving.
Yeah, okay. Unmounting, okay. Yeah. So, okay, so, welcome. No, you're there. Okay.
Oh,
I was going to welcome you.
No, I'm live now.
Live. Okay. So, oh, seriously, unmount. Oh, you finished because you started early. Now
no,
I get it. Huh? Oh, come on. When I started, then you started. So you started with me. It's done as well?
Oh, long
time. Okay, I'm done. Thank God. Okay, who is not done? Done?
Who is not done?
Done?
Done, yep.
Okay, like, yep. Okay. Yes, sir.
Done.
Dude, it done. Yes, sir. Pasting? Oh, okay. We're going to do it together then. Okay, guys, so when you expand these folders, that's where our work area starts.
What?
Who said system administration was easy? But this is a one-time thing, and if you go through it, and you're going to understand the logic of it. Once you understand the logic, it's still going to be that lengthy, but you will understand the logic. So
okay. Okay.
You want me to say that it's going to be easy?
Will you be honest? Do you think network administration is easier than system administration? No?
I think, yeah.
Okay.
Network administration is easier than system.
You're honest. Now I believe you.
Now I believe you. Before you didn't. Okay. Seriously, I'm going to throw something now.
You give us PDF, that will help a lot.
Yeah, that PDF,
yeah,
I had to create the whole line. So all the students were able to do that easily. It was in the final exam number as well. They had to do the lab. So let's just create the new answer file here. And then we start adding information from this area to that area one by one, and then put all the information here as well. It's not gonna be, well, it's just that once you create an answer file for 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, 4 year, it just, you know, it's a one-time thing.
One by one,
a couple of million steps. Yeah, so it's not million. I'm just trying to create some panic here. Oh, bad idea. So let's just go back here and create an answer file. Right click, new answer file. So right click under the answer file on that create. Everyone there? So new answer file, just click it like this and it should open like this. So some of these areas we're gonna fix. At least we're going to do minimum configuration. We're gonna do minimum configuration where the machine never stops anywhere. So those initial windows were just 5 or 6. When we installed Windows 8, remember that there were 5 or 6 windows only. Those all answers we're gonna create here. Other than that, you can also customize this machine as well. You can, you know, change settings in the Internet Explorer, you can change settings anywhere else. But we're gonna go for the minimum most where we don't have to touch anything after starting the empty machine. We're not gonna touch anything else. It's gonna start and finish at logon, right? So what is the minimum? Let's go and start adding. If I go to PDF, this is the first thing we added under this Windows pre-installation environment. So what did we add? So if you see the line AMD 64, Microsoft Windows International, there are only two lines that have the word international there. The second line, International Core WinPE, is the one we're going to select. So if I go back now to the Windows here, if I go start, expand the components, expand this components area, right? Components. Now, international should be just two lines. There it is. International Core WinPE. Everyone was able to find that?
Yep.
Exactly, the second international one. So if we expand that, there's only one other option, but we right click it So right click this line and select this one. Add setting to pass one, passage one, which is that first area of configuration.
So it moves automatically.
Yes, exactly. When you click that, yes.
So this one, the images from the AMD system, that's the processor, right? Or the AMD system?
Exactly. That's always the question. Microsoft, I don't know why they are using instead of Intel or AMD, but Microsoft uses for 32-bit hardware, x86 word, and for 64-bit hardware, they use AMD instead of Intel. So it has nothing to do with processor itself.
So it's not the AMD processor.
No. It is just 64-bit and 32-bit, whichever hardware.
I think what I think is they have taken that processor from AMD.
Wherever you go in certain more software when we are configuring, they always give the choice of, do you want to go for x86? If there's a 32-bit and 64-bit choice, x86 or AMD 64, or just AMD. Then I went to the TechNet forums, and you can also Google that. The Microsoft says 64-bit. Means 64-bit for anything written AMD 64, but it has nothing to do with the actual AMD processor itself. Because right now we are selecting this option for, and we all have Intel processors, so it should not work if it is the processor itself it's referring, right? So if we are there now, everyone has added like this. On the right side, you see input locale, system locale, and this is the local language and the keyboard setting. So if I go to the PDF again and see this, English US. So EN-US, except for the second line, we're gonna be putting English-US on all those. And let me just see the watch the second screen as well. Then we go for the setup UI language and put English US there as well. So now I'm gonna do that, follow me. So first is click that. Everyone must have clicked that. So here, EN dash in caps US. Right? EN dash, then press shift and US. It should be capital, right? And answer file in some cases is very specific. So control C, select the EN US, and exactly as you said, copy paste. Sorry? It is English US, EN-US. So EN-US control, then I selected it, copied it, and I'm pasting it on the third line. Again, and until I reach the last line. It should exactly look like this. So this is answering the first ever screen that comes, which is talking only about language and keyboard settings, right? We are answering that now. So it should not stop there, right?
So how do we know it is asking us about language by reading only on?
Oh, this is not going to be very clear here.
Yeah.
So TechNet documents translates everything. So that's why I said one full night I had to just create the whole screenshots and everything.
Okay.
So, but everything can be looked up. Google Master is there, right? And it's always, I recommend that you do research. Whenever you have a question, you're kind of like want to know more, go Google it as well. It's always good idea. Yep. Okay, select setup language. So everyone did that except for the second one. So then go for setup UI language, the second one here, and paste the same thing like this. Everyone did that? Second one, right? If you expand that, expand like this. So the second one, right? Everyone there, right?
Yes.
Okay. So let's go for, okay, Shaul, where you are? Did you select that? And did that, right? Okay. So I'm just gonna go quickly to the second one. Now we get the idea, we're adding it this way. So this all information came from where? Everyone remembers that?
Yes, international.
This all information came from where?
From any?
No.
Or from the image.
Yes, install.vim. The rest of the Windows installation file, we got all the information from there. So let's go back and let's go for second one. So second one is AMD 64, Microsoft Windows, but it says setup and underscore 6.3. There's, I think, setup. With setup, there's only one line which shows setup. You saw that? Okay, and then what we're supposed to do, I'm just gonna go for, in the setup, you have to select disk configuration. So first we have to search for setup, then we go expand that, then we go for disk configuration and add it as well to the passage one. I'm just seeing the next few screens. Okay, that's it. So I'm just gonna go now. So Windows setup 6.3 and then disk configuration to be added. So now I'm just gonna do that. So where's AD setup? Windows S. That was a PDF, right? Now I'm gonna do that. So I'm going for Windows setup. So MPS there. This. It is in the I was just testing. I knew that. No, I'm just kidding. I forgot that. Okay. So setup underscore 6.3. And so setup underscore 6.3. And disk configuration, right click. Everyone there? Right? So to the pass one as well. So now it should look like this. There? Cool. This configuration looks like this, right? So what do we do with that? So PDF file, going back to that. So then it is disk configuration. That's what we added. So click that. Then we go downer. Okay, and we are adding Windows deployment in the same area. Disk configuration area, we did that already. Then we go for Windows deployment as well. Windows deployment as well.
So
and
disk configuration we like to.
So, okay.
Disk.
When you select disk configuration, right click and add pass and click that.
Add
was it done by everyone?
Pass one.
Yeah, click that.
Okay.
So I already did that, right?
Yes.
So then again, in the same line, go down to Windows Deployment Services because we are using WDS, right? So it needs some information about that as well. So WDS and same thing, exact same thing. Add pass one again. The last one, Windows Deployment Services. Mr. Shahid, you're there?
Yes.
Good.
Right click.
So everyone there? Yes.
Yeah.
Right click and pass one.
There.
Yeah. So now it should look like disk configuration and Windows Deployment Services.
Now you have to give the parameters.
Exactly. So what are the parameters?
Okay,
let's go and check it out. Okay, disk configuration, insert new disk. I'm gonna check the next two, three pictures and then we're gonna do it together. So disk configuration, right click and then insert new disk. After that, insert new disk, then we go for zero and true here. So let's just do that first. So insert new disk and click that and zero and true. So let's do that. I'm just gonna do that now. Disk configuration, right click, insert new disk, right? Disk configuration, right click, insert new disk. When you see that, the disk shows. If you expand that, well, still the disk shows. And on the right side, disk ID is zero. You know why it is zero? In physical, when you have a main board and you put the first disk, it always starts with zero. In partitions, when you're partitioning, it always starts with
one.
Partitioning when you're doing partitioning, right? So when it's a physical disk, it's always it starts with zero. So it's saying go to zero disk and format that. Wipe disk, true. Wipe disk, we all know, format, right? Format the disk. So we're telling it's a new machine for select the first one. Maybe you have four disks there. So don't go for 1, 2, and 3. Go for zero and format that, right? So it's all automatically being done. So now let's just go. It is done for everyone? Okay. Sorry? Shall? That zero and true. The below option, bottom option is drop down, which is true. Got it? Okay, so again, here, zero, true. I'm going for the next picture. Create partition. First, it formats the disk. It selects the first disk, formats it. Now, we're telling it to create a partition. And this will be going on for 100 or 1,000 computers if, you know, the instructions were done properly. So this insert partition, right click the insert partition, go for insert new credit partition. I'm gonna try to see the 3-4 pictures and go ahead. When you have new partition, create partition, now there are a lot of things here to be filled.
What did we do before the create partition?
Then the plus. Right click create partition. Oh, you're doing it now. That's good. Right click create partition, insert new create partition. Then go for create partition. So now what values we need to put, I'm just trying to look that as well. Then I'm gonna start with the create partition. So the values are extend is true, yes, extend it. Order is one, first partition. And type is primary, so the operating system could boot from there, right? So I'm just remembering that. I hope I remember that. True, one, primary. True, one, primary. True,
the
okay.
Default value came false.
Sorry?
The default value came false.
Yeah, so it should be true, right? So true, one, primary. So I'm just remembering that. Now I'm gonna go back and do that, right? So here, create partition, right click that. Insert new create partition. Everyone doing that? Right?
Yeah.
So insert new create partition. After that, of course, or false is extended, extend the partition true. Order is
one
and type is
primary.
So it should boot the hard disk, right? So now everyone did that?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
Order
let's
one.
Yeah, order one, type primary. So 911 did that? Okay. Oh, 911, come on. Chukandar was not gifted to 911. So, okay, done, cool. So PDF, let's go ahead. But disk was, we were told that disk should be formatted, first disk, and then we told create first partition and it should be primary so the operating system could boot. The all instructions are clear. Let's go ahead. Then modify partitions. We go there and right click the modify partition as well. And again, insert new modify partition. So first we create the partition, then we modify the partition. And
the
then
same partition we are modifying.
Yeah.
If we create.
Yeah. So when there's modify partition here, then I'm gonna see two or three more pictures and come back and do that. Now there are lots of values here. Modify partition.
Oh, yeah.
So it should look like this.
Okay
guys, if you know what to do, I'm just gonna keep the screen here. If anyone started that already. If not, then I'm gonna start that now. So if you go for modify partition. Did you right click and create, everyone created the modify partition?
Yes.
Everyone did that, right?
Yes.
And then when you go down, now go for first is true, second is false, format yes it has to be on TFS, label it's you have to give the label yourself, system, letter is C. Obviously this is how we always create the first partition or for the operating system, but this is going to be done automatically, right? Partition ID is 1, order is 1 as well. So oh yeah. So let me know if everyone has done that so I could do that too. Oh, done? Okay. Sorry? ID is nothing. ID is nothing.
Okay,
done. Done? 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 911? Okay.
Oh.
Yeah, but is the memory good? Okay, very good actually. So, hey, whoever's memory is good, can you also tell me? So, modify partition, right click, insert new modify partition, and then active is true, extend is
false,
format is NTFS, label is system, and letter is C11, okay. 11. Thank you guys. So, okay, let's go ahead. No pains, no gains. Now, Windows Deployment Services. We did add that, now we are adding the values, right? So, Windows Deployment Services, you can expand that. Then expand again, image selection. Then you click install image. Install image has file name, image group, image name. Now this you have to follow me. So let's just go there first. Windows Deployment Services. And then install image. I'm just going there now first. Yeah, I'm just showing that.
Okay.
So Windows Deployment Services here.
Yeah.
And image selection.
Install image, right click.
Install image.
And number one.
Guys, now it's gonna be, we have to be very careful now. These parameters are different for majority of us. Most of us, it's gonna be different. So where to go and check these parameters? This is where we are telling answer file which image to use for this. So we're gonna go for, now I'm gonna go, okay. Windows System Image Manager, this is the one, right? Keep it open, keep it at this option, stay, keep it this, and go down. Is this WDS console still open for everyone? WDS console is still open for everyone?
Yes. Yeah.
If not, then open the WDS console. If open, just click it, right? WDS console is open for everyone, right? Yeah. So when we go ahead and we go to install images,
yeah.
Accounts department, Windows 8.1 Enterprise Evaluation. This is the first install we did, right?
Yes.
So when we right click this, and properties. Everyone there?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
I
don't get properties. No, click it. You have the 8.1 enterprise? You have the 8.1 enterprise? First select it. Okay. Got it, right? Okay, right click properties.
Yeah.
Now this screen opens. All our answers are here on the screen. So now if I go back, keep it open. I'm gonna go back and check this out. File name, image group, image name, right? Now I'll show you the PDF file as well. So if we go, how did we fill it in the PDF? So we went to that 8.1 enterprise image in the PDF. There is that 8.1 enterprise, which is the file name. Then, oh, no, sorry, wait. There's this information, there's file name here, and there is this information. So how did we put it there? Let's just go and see that. Install dash, this may be different for you.
Yes.
Maybe there's no two there. So you have to see your own information there. So image group was, in our case, accounts department. Image name is exact full name of the image. So let me go and take that. Let's go for file name. Where's file name? So, so yeah, if we go there, file name is this. Everyone there?
Yeah.
I think every one of us is install.wim. Is it?
Yes.
Install.wim. Everyone?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Mr. Shaya? Are you on the right click? Everyone right clicked it, and when you right click, don't close it, right? Shall? Okay, I'll close that. Where are you? Are you on this? Install images?
Yeah, I already opened
it. Right click and properties.
Yeah.
Did you open that? So do you see file name somewhere?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. So try to open that again.
Yeah,
other one? Oh, that Windows System Image Manager?
Yeah,
it will be down.
No, so go down on the taskbar like this. It should be this icon. This one. You got it? That must not be closed, guys. Otherwise, we lose a lot if that Windows System is. So, install.vim is the file name. So, I'm just going to put that there right away here. This is now the windows that are open in one computer that we are switching to,
mm-hmm.
Right? So the file name, I'm just gonna put install.wim, right? The image group name is, I think, accounts department. Yeah, we can copy paste. That's even better. Yeah, that's better actually. That's a good idea. So then again, if I go back, What is the
accounts department?
Accounts department. So I'm just gonna, as Mr. Shahid said,
yeah,
it's better to right click and copy.
Yeah.
Right. So we should all have that same breakfast tomorrow. So
yes.
Image group, space. Who's gonna provide that?
They are the very cheap on sale.
So yeah, don't just go ahead and buy your own and
yeah,
don't bug me. Okay. So
the
guys, what is the image name?
Yeah, that I didn't find.
Install that. Oh, the image name or image group?
This.
Oh yeah, that's it.
This,
yeah,
one. Okay.
This one is the image name.
This
is on the top, right? You got it?
Yeah.
Image name?
Evaluation thing?
Yeah. On the top, it's just that,
yes,
written, right? Everyone sees that, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Everyone sees that? Ola did not say yes, so it just means...
Yes, sure. I pasted it.
Oh, already. And Shahul?
Yes.
Yes.
This yes or means no. So, so copy and paste that. Oops. So now we're telling which image to mess with. Oh, okay, actually, to deploy without attending it. Okay, if you click this, it's selected, right? So install image is done for everyone?
Yes.
It should look like this.
Yeah.
Okay, let's go ahead. Yeah, yeah. It should look like this. It should start, this one starts like this, Windows 8.1, the image name. No, better to copy paste because
it could be case sensitive, right?
It could be case sensitive and the space is
the Windows Enterprise.
Don't this one, don't type. Copy paste. This one especially. If the spaces are even not there, that could be problem. And if you're deploying it on 100 computers and it messes up, whoa. Then we, yeah, kinda. Or we can just check on first machine first and then we go ahead. Okay, if this is done and it looks like for everyone like this, let's go ahead. PDF, yes, it should look like this. So I'm just gonna go check the rest of the pictures. Install to, right into the install image, which we just gave the values on, there is install to as well.
So here I think we will
install to which partition? Which disk, which partition?
Oh.
So we chose the image, we told answer file choose this image, but where to deploy that? So disk 0, which we just formatted, and partition 1, which we just created, right? So install 2, and disk ID is 0, partition ID is 1, so 01, that's it, right? I'm just gonna do that now.
Yeah.
Install 2, disk ID is 0, partition ID is, seriously, it doesn't tab to go there. Okay, so everyone did that?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay, let's go quickly ahead, but we do understand the instructions that are being given or being fed into the answer file. Okay, now do you see login as well?
Yeah.
Expand that. Under the install to, which we already gave, there's login, extend that, then click credentials. What are the credentials?
Domain,
password, username. So here, if I go down, oh, it's humberdomain.local, well, that not over. And so net plus domain.local, net plus admin, and you know, the password, class password. So I'm just gonna do that now. Okay, let's go ahead, login, expand, credentials, net plus, it's not case sensitive, I'm just putting for spelling, net plus domain.local. Password, small ABC, capital ABC, shift 123. If you did not give this password, give that password which you gave for the domain admin.
Username, net plus admin, right?
Exactly.
Username should be net plus admin.
Yeah. User one? No, whoever is the domain admin. Which account is the domain admin? It's net plus admin. Because we right click and copy that domain administrator account,
right,
and then create a net plus admin. So it has all the powers of domain administrator, right? Okay. So net plus admin, net plus domain dot local. Did I give a space here?
Thinking is,
yep,
in my opinion.
Yeah.
You are giving the full control to general public.
No.
Because you are doing 1,000 computers.
No, this is not that. This is asking who has the privilege to deploy this. So this account has a privilege to deploy. Yeah. Right. Okay. So if we go to PDF again, just a couple of million more steps left. No, it's just we are nearing the end.
Really?
No, I'm just kidding. So,
well,
those who can still sit for the video, I need to complete that. Those who want to leave at 2 can leave, but those who want to follow me after 2 can still sit and follow me. But for the video, now I have to really.
But
do
I
that.
Heard they have next class that starts
at 2. Yeah, no, it's okay. If you want to go at 2, go.
205.
Right? So, okay, it's done. Tools, validate answer file. That's the only thing we need to do. Tools, validate answer file, and then save it. So I'm just going to go to the next screen and check where to save. Then we go to file, then we select save. It's saving inside the remote install. C, remote install, WDS client unattended. This is a special folder already created for any unattended file that we create. So, and the file name we're giving is whatever, but here we are giving WDS unattended client file. So I'm gonna do that now. First, we go back.
Mine is saving in a different location, is it okay?
It's okay. No.
See? A good thing I asked you.
Yeah, and it's a good thing that you didn't do it and then asked.
No.
Oh, yeah.
Ask
is,
and do.
He's slow actually. Otherwise, he would do that.
Yeah.
Save answer file, right?
Yeah.
That's what we chose.
So, let's do that and let me show you now.
Okay, let's do it.
So, tools, validate answer file. First, that.
Okay.
Tools, you were saying? Yep. Tools, validate answer file. Everyone there?
Yeah.
Click if there are no errors.
Yeah.
Showing here, down. In the bottom, no warnings or errors, right? That's good. File,
oh, good.
And then save answer file. Save, everyone there? File, save answer file. When you save, yeah.
Save.
So now we go to this PC, go to C drive, this PC, C drive, and C, yeah, you're there. Your 911 today. you are about to be promoted today. So okay. So C, and then remote install here. C drive, remote install.
This PC.
This PC, yeah. And then C drive.
C drive.
Then remote install.
Yeah.
And then WDS client unattended.
Yes.
This is a folder that is specified for this kind of on you know files. Continue, yes, whatever. And then go for
continue. Currently permission to access.
So click continue. Is there an option for continue? Yeah.
Continue.
Yes, sir.
I'm lost in the middle.
Okay. Because
no, he was not chatting at all.
Yeah, okay, so no, that's good. There was a you know witness here.
No,
so.
I can see that.
But
go to tools, tools.
Yeah,
validate answer file.
WDS unattended.
I have to be strict with it. Okay.
Strict
now,
with it.
Go back.
Bishum.
Yeah.
Bishum.
Keep quiet. I'll this
okay, I should also.
File.
Now he's in form.
Answer file.
One message.
Yes or no?
Save answer
file.
This
message. Depends on the message. What's the message? Yes. Go for yes. Yes. Okay. WDS unattended client.
Now you
remote.
Now you go to after C where
remote.
So okay, that
remote
was
install.
Only 25% of Chukandar UI. Oh, okay. Anyway,
install.
So remote install.
Remote install. Double
then WDS unattended.
Then WDS unattended. Yes,
double click.
Yes. Client.
Double click.
Yes. Yes.
Double click that.
Yes.
Double click.
And then
continue.
Yes.
Yes.
You're ahead of Shahid now.
Now
you can just type this name.
Okay.
So WDS unattended client 1. Right?
You have to type it.
Yeah, type the name as well.
Type.
Oh man.
WDS.
Nothing is easy in this world, especially in system administration. So WDS unattended client. It's just, you know, something related to that. It's not compulsory you give just this file name. It could be, you know, anything. So WDS Unidentified Client 1, it's up to you. Right? So click save, everyone.
Save.
Yeah. Shovel.
Okay. So done.
Save.
Done. Cool.
Save.
Done.
Save.
Very good.
Done
for the day. We are kind of near our objective.
I put in client 1. I didn't put client 1. I put only client 1.
Which is okay.
That,
you should not be that specific. Not exactly. Okay. So anyway, so let's go save, everyone.
Yeah.
Done?
Yeah.
Okay, save. And the next steps.
You didn't have the permissions.
No, do you click continue or press yes? So right now he's in form. Everyone brace for, you know, what Mr. Shahid says. Yeah. Yes. It's 2 o'clock already.
I start activity.
Yeah, Shaul?
Whichever name we choose, the name will reflect on our Windows system image manager, right? The name will reflect on there, right?
Whatever file name you choose now is just for our reference. Nothing else. Yeah, okay. Guys, so we have selected that. The only few options left. So we have to go to the server now and attach this file to the image. So which image are we talking about? First of all, where to go? On the server of WDS, the WDS console we go. Then we right-click in properties. Then there is that tab called client. I'm just showing that, then I'm going to do that. So, and then we go for enable unattended solution. I'm just going through the option. Then x64 architecture browse. And then, that's it. And then this file has to be given. So let me just do that now. On server one, keep this window open. Don't close this one. And go down. We are inside the WDS console. Now we don't need this one. We do not need this one. Cancel. So WDS console, everyone there. Server one, right click. So make sure everyone is on this screen. Yeah. The WDS console, server one, right click properties. There?
Yeah.
Oops. So yeah, you have to just go down and go to the WDS console. Yes. Everyone there? There, Shaul?
Yes.
There.
Okay, yes.
911 is not there. Mr. Idris? Wait.
Idris. Don't say
Idris.
Address.
Okay.
Yes, properties.
Properties.
Yes.
And then we go for client. The tab is client. Then we go for x64. Oh, first enable it, sorry. Then we go for x64 architecture.
Oh.
And browse. The third one. Everyone on the third one?
Yes.
Where do we go then? Browse. When you go browse, where do you go?
WDS client under 10.
Yes, WDS client under 10. Double click, and the only file we created there, we're just going to double click that.
So that
never saved there? That screen is still open, Windows System Image Manager?
Yeah.
Okay, so we can try again. So let me just do that. So everyone selected this?
Yes.
So can you try again to save it? Save. You there on the save button on the Windows System Image Manager?
Yes.
And when you go to file? So PDF file here, just few more steps. Okay, so yeah, we did that. Then we create a new answer file. Okay, so we're creating a new answer file, but this is going to be only 3 or 4 more modifications. Yeah.
One second. So we apply and hit OK.
And hit OK, exactly.
Apply
and hit OK. So you're right. Did I do that?
No.
So let me just check that.
Actually, when I was there, choose unattended file and I selected.
Oh yeah, I did not do that. So enable unattended, as you said, apply exactly, and okay. Apply okay. Then we go for WSIM again, Windows System Image Manager, which is already open there, like this, everyone. And then we go for, so this answer file is already created. One answer file created. Second answer file, we're just gonna go up. This answer file does not have this many options. This answer file, second one, has less options. So file, new answer file. So, yeah. Yeah, that's cool. Thank you.
Okay.
So, Mr. Shai, you're there? In the WSIM.
Yes, I am.
New answer file?
New answer file? Mr. Shai is coming there. New answer file?
New answer file,
yeah. What are you doing? No, just kidding. So, now new answer file? Okay, new answer file?
Yes, yes.
Okay, now we there are just few more, three or four, two or three
so
lines
why
more.
We are doing this second line?
This needs to be attached to the image itself. Before, previous file was attached to the WDS console only. WDS now knows that we are messing with or we are trying to deploy that particular image. WDS need to know first. Now this file will tell the image itself what to do. So first we tell server what to do. And then we tell the image itself, there are some things image you have to do as well. So this the second answer file is very short. And
okay.
That tells very small amount of things to the image itself. Mm-hmm. Main things we told the WDS console. So that's why we attached it to the console, not the image. Now this one, we're going to attach to the image itself.
Okay.
So PDF, now I'm going to go a little faster because we know the drill. So if we go down, shell setup, we did not touched before. So it is Microsoft Windows shell setup. I think shell is only one line. There's no other line that says that. So we're gonna go for AMD 64 Microsoft Windows shell setup 6.3. I think everyone is there, right?
Yes.
Shell
is only one line.
Yes.
I'm sure about that.
Yeah.
So if we go for the second screenshot, now when we right click that, there are many other areas that we can add it to, but we're gonna see which area we need to add that. To 4. So this means if I go back, it's the this one, add setting to pass 4 specialize, right?
Okay.
Add setting to pass 4 specialize. When we add that, so I'm just gonna go further to that. See, very few options here, seriously. Okay, so then we go back and see what are the values that we give. Still, it's there, and let me just show the values. Skip this. TZ util tells you that, you know, how the standard time is shown. But let me just show you what is added here. So computer name, we can add any of our, you know, any name you want to give. Win8Client01. We're giving here product key. I'm gonna send you the product key. Registered organization, company name, registered owner, Windows user. Time zone is Eastern Standard Time. You can see here the spellings are wrong. Eastern. So even then it worked fine. So it's just something we put. So now, yeah. So we can openly make mistake here. So if you didn't make a mistake, make mistake. If you were not planning to do that. So anyway,
okay.
So I'm going to keep that screen here. I'm going to go there and reach to this screen. So here I'm going to go for shell setup, which is just one line. So right click, pass 4. I think everyone did that,
yes.
Right? Everyone there, right?
Four.
Okay.
Four.
When is there, then now those options there. I think nobody filled that, right?
No. Okay.
Computer name is?
Win8.
Client.
Client.
Okay, one. Win8 client one, right? But it could be others as well. So product name, or product key name. Is it gonna stop at product key? Sorry? Zoom further?
Yeah.
Wow. Now this is Zoom 3X. Okay, product key. So first is computer name Windows Red Client, right? Second is product key. Let's just fill the other ones and I'm going to send you the product key now. The registered organization, Tasty Samosas Factory. Hey, this is a serious professional name. Come on. Okay. It's an organization name. You just name it, right? It's already lunchtime, so samosa comes to mind that there should be a company like that. And it's not Tasty, it's Tasty. So, anyway, Windows user and time zone is? Eastern Canada. Was it Canada? Oops. Yeah, why did I put Canada? Eastern Standard Time. Okay, so let me just.
I think you need to also type zone.
No, when you put R and N, it looks like M.
Oh.
So, zone? So, see, it's R and this is N. So, anyway, Eastern Time Zone? Okay,
yes.
Zone. So, Eastern Time Zone, Windows 8 Client, and the product key. Guys, for the product key, of course, you have to go to the shop and buy that from there. And doing it now. Yeah, so I purchased that key from the shop and I'm just gonna copy that now. I went to the shop and there it is. And I don't want to show you. Oh, is that okay?
Who's typing on the notepad?
Okay, resume now. So everyone has put something there?
Yes.
Okay, so let's go ahead a little and further options are it should look like this. Eastern Standard Time, okay, zone as well. Windows user, company name.
Setting value is not value. That is the product key element is in value.
What? So try.
Maybe I added the one, the extra Z.
Yeah, so yeah. Just put the correct key there. So I'm just gonna go quickly to the remaining of the shots. So there is that AMD 64 Microsoft Windows unattended join. So it's gonna join the domain as well. So can you see unattended join? This is all also just one line in under the U. Unattended join.
After key, go to.
Yeah, after key, just go there. Unattended join. Yeah. So then. And it should be added to pass 4 specialized as well. It's the only option. And then I'm just looking for those shots here.
What is the Microsoft on that?
After you do nothing, just paste and go to.
And then go here. See this? Hummer domain or local join domain. Okay, so these are certain steps. So I'm just going to go there now and do it now. So I'm on server 1. And if I. Go for unattended join, it should be in under U.
Yep.
Unattended join here, right click, there's only one option here.
Yep.
Pass, so everyone did that?
Yes.
Pass 4 specialize. When we go there on the right side, do you see further options? Everyone was able to add that? Unattended join? Shaul, you were?
Yeah.
Okay, Shaul. On the left side, do you see unattended join? Keep going down to until you see alphabetical. After the Windows, everything is alphabetical. After the word Windows. So go to U. Right click and, you know, there's only one option. Join. So go for identification there and identification. So expand that unattended join. Go to identification. Expand that. Join domain. Which domain?
Net
plus domain dot local here. Okay. Now I've zoomed it more, so the whole thing shows here. Everyone has added the unattended join. Yes, Mr. Idris.
Yeah.
You've added the added it right?
Done. I'm just putting the domain name.
Okay. Everyone did that? Shaul, you did that? typing. Let us be in our local, right?
Oh.
Oh.
Other class.
2 o'clock. You need to go?
Yeah.
Okay, guys. This was the last of it, but yeah, if we have to just. That's it.
That's it?
No, that's it for the screen. Yeah. Look who's talking. Okay, so credentials, click the credentials and all the credentials the same again. Net plus domain dot local. So the next is credentials, right?
Yes, the same thing.
Yeah, Amber domain dot local, password, username, right? So that's on credentials. Everyone sees that? Yes, sir.
Sorry, what is the domain?
Oh, that's this document was for Humber.
Netplusdomain.local.
Okay. Right? So I'm just going to go there and go for credentials. So credentials here. And domain, of course, this is the easy part. Password. Net plus admin. Okay, everyone did that?
Yes.
Okay, let's do it faster because I have to go somewhere. So, credentials, then let's go for next screenshots here. Credentials, yep. Oops. Maybe take. No, then we go for international core. Yep. International core underscore 6.3.
There's two of them there.
International core, but
the
not the WinPE, but the 6.3. Yeah, everyone found that?
Yep.
International core?
Yes.
And it's it has to be added to
6.3.
The top, first one.
Right click
and add it to pass 7.
7 this time?
7 this time.
Oh, we're improving.
Hey.
Oh, changing his mind.
So then when it's added to 7, I'm going to show you the value added changes. ENUS for all of them. International core, ENUS for all of them. So I'm just going to quickly go there and do that. So let me just show you there. International core. It should be going up now.
Copy, paste.
There you go. So international core, right click. Pass 7,
yeah.
And when we reach there, here, everyone sees this page?
Yes.
It's EN-US, and then copy and paste it on the rest of them. Paste. Right? Everyone did that?
Yes.
How come, Mr. Idris? Oh, it sounds good. Oh, yeah, the lunch. Somebody has just opened the lunch. Okay, Mr. Idris? Ooh. Hey, there's something going on there. How come you're always behind? I think you're writing as well. Yes?
No, he cannot write.
Oh.
He can do one.
Uh-oh. Okay, I'm recording now, right? Okay, Windows International Core. Did you write that down?
Yes.
Okay, cool. And quickly go to Venezuela, blah blah blah. Oh,
now
in the shell setup, seriously, yeah, that's done, right?
Yes.
Okay, then we again go to shell setup and add OOBE. So, shell setup is only one line, right? Shell. So, after Windows, it's shell setup. Everyone see that? Shell setup. After Windows goes just for shell. That. No, this is different now. This is different.
Neutral, right?
This is the. So before we did international core, Now we're going for shell.
How many
stuff?
There's one starting with
the
AMD64.
Yeah, shell setup. Okay, OOBE.
And OOBE?
Yeah. Order of the British Empire.
Whoa, I didn't know that. Okay, no, it starts with AMD 64, Microsoft, Windows. Oh, actually, every line starts with that. So, OOBE, everyone, so which one are we choosing? 7, right? There's only one option, right? And when we add, seriously, okay. So, there are so many options here, values. So, how does it look like? True, true, nothing, true, true, work, 1. So, that's the best way to remember that. If you're already there, are you already on this page?
I am there, but...
So, let me just add that and come here. Let me add that. So, where's the shell?
See, yeah, this about this is slightly above where you are. 6.3.
Shell setup is this, right?
No. There's something happening, I don't understand.
This shell.
So, OOBE, yes.
And then OOBE.
Yeah.
Okay, right click, pass 7. Everyone edit that?
Yeah.
So now it's going to be, let me just put that on. If everyone is there, see this.
I don't see pass 7.
Oh, right click the shell setup, right?
Oh,
right click the OOBE actually.
Right
click OOBE.
There's something happening.
So everyone sees this page.
It's not taking a true
and all that. No, it's a drop down.
Yeah,
I think. Go to OOBE. Go to OOBE.
Okay.
Did you add OOBE or shell setup? Shahul? Go for OOBE inside shell setup. Right click and add OOBE.
Okay, I wait for you to get
there.
Yep. So true true space true true work space 1. Oh. Hey, we got a new student.
Can you
okay.
Read that, please?
Oh. Yeah, that's good. Is everyone there? No, okay. Wow. I need to take picture. Everyone there, guys?
Yes, yes.
You did that
I just
already? Oh, okay.
To find my drop down.
Are we doing WDS?
Yeah.
Oh.
The zero touch. Okay. So hide Eula page was which one is that? Anyone did that already?
Yes.
So
yeah,
can you just tell me? Is it the first line?
True. Yeah.
True.
True.
Second one is true as well.
Yeah. Third is blank.
Online accounts.
True.
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 Blank. Blank.
Blank.
Network location work.
Work.
Oh, sorry.
No,
work.
No, 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 no.
Work.
That says other.
Protect your PC. Protect your PC is 1. There's Mr. Disruption here. I think. Yeah.
My name is showing the drop down.
So add again. Are you on OOBE or are you on here?
I am on OOBE for sure.
This one.
Yep.
So, go back here and add OOBE again. Right click and.
Right click.
You
have to be strict with it.
Yeah.
Okay, so guys.
How specific do you want it?
Yeah. Specific, no, strict, he says.
Yeah, true, that's not true. It's not working. Okay, it's working now.
It's working now.
It's working
yeah.
now.
Okay, so guys, I hope this is the last one, so I'm just gonna go for.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, forget it. Forget it. Oh, then we finish it. Although you get the idea, so how long do we have? 3 o'clock meeting?
Yeah, we're going to be there by 3. Well, we should be there by
1:45.
Okay, so.
Apparently it's 20 minutes.
Okay, guys.
Give me another few
minutes.
Huh? Zarg's having something.
Okay. Oh, it's Mazarik eating.
Oh, yeah.
That's why we can smell so much good. So, guys, so how do we add user accounts? Sorry. Yeah. How do you add user accounts here?
Add to.
Where are the user accounts? First, on the same line we had OOBE.
Yeah.
Now, on the same line, there are user accounts. Anyone sees that?
Yes.
So, when you have user accounts, where do we add that? Under 7. User accounts have to be added under 7. right? So where are user accounts? Where we went for OB,
yeah.
Right in that line below is user accounts as well. Everyone sees that? It
yes.
looks like this.
Yeah.
Shahul?
Yes.
It's the same line where you added OB. Yeah, user accounts. And then 7. Okay, let's go ahead and user accounts and then the password. Administrator password is this. So I'm just going to go quickly there and do that now. So in the same line, shell, the same shell line. Seriously? User accounts here.
Right
click. 7. Now user accounts are added as well. So when you expand that, there's administrator password. This is the local administrator password, right? So in case something happens and it cannot join the domain, then you must have local account access. Otherwise, if you don't do that, the local administrator password by default is disabled, right? By default, right? So administrator, right? Everyone did that?
Yes.
Okay. So first thing is administrator password. Next thing. Local account. We create a new account. Okay, that was domain administrator. Then we create a new local account as well.
What about domain account?
No, that was the domain. That was not the domain account. That was the local administrator account.
Okay.
Local administrator is by default there, right?
Yeah,
now we're creating an extra local account as well, right? So, do you see under administrator password the local account?
Yes.
Yes. So, insert new local account. We can click that.
Right.
And when we have insert new local account, see this information. If you have already done that, this is information we are putting there. Action is add list item. I think this is already there.
Yeah.
Description is sysadmin, display name sysadmin, group is administrators. We are creating a new account that is part of the local administrators group, having the same powers as the local administrator. So if you see this screen, you can fill it up now. Are you seeing this? Do it done? Except for Shahul? No, Shahul is also doing it.
No.
That is so good. You did that? Hey, that was good. Okay. The script, did everyone did that?
Yeah.
So let me do that too.
Administrators.
No, this is the group there. I think it's drop down or something. Just type the administrators which group to join this local account that we are creating in all those empty machines, right? In those newly installed machines. So this is what we're doing, right?
Okay. Next.
So now I'm going to do that too quickly. So local accounts, right click, insert new local account, and then go for description, sysadmin, control A, control C, add administrators, MD administrators, no. Administrators.
Or admin.
Sysadmin. It could be any account. You can just type your name as well, right? But which group you want to add, that has to be specific administrators group, right? Sysadmin or any other name you can put here. Okay, so I'm just going to go back to the last of the few thousand screenshots. So the password for the local administrator account. And the password is class password.
On the name sysadmin, the last one
is also sysadmin.
It is same setting value is not valid.
Then remove the name and put the name again. And type the name. SYSADMIN. In the last one, right?
Because we used the other one, that's why it's rejected. I edited my own name.
Just give your own name then, sysadmin 1, if you want.
I just put S.
Mr. Shahid, you can see on the board.
Administrators. Okay. Just a second.
Second is over. Yep.
Is he always this low?
Yeah.
And it's 2 o'clock and yeah, Mr. Shahid is in form, so brace yourself. Oh.
Number one to
his
system.
Okay. Okay.
So why is giving me error message?
I hope that was a good time to answer this.
We already created the name.
I wanna run now. So guys, you're not able to
okay,
write this? Hey, I'm really questioning that Chukandar now. So, okay, okay, let's go ahead. Guys, you're all done?
Yeah.
Yes, yes.
So, password, did you write the password as well?
No. Yes, password. Password is done.
Done.
We have a password?
Okay,
done, 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 done.
Regular password.
Done, sir. Done.
Okay. Thank God, we reached there. So, I mean, like this screen, right? So, Okay, anyways, I'll just put the password and finish this nice lab. So, where's the password here? Just going for the password here, and ABC, the password has to be El Correcto. So, once that is done, let's just go for save the file, right? Everyone there to save the file? Save the file, everyone. So when you click save now, save once a file. So it same window opens, but what is the file name? OOBE unattended. Well, that's just to make different file name. So I'm just naming the file name as OOBE unattended. So I'm gonna go back there. Where are we now? File name. OOBE unattended.
That's it?
Save it. Yeah. Click
save.
Yep. Yeah. Save.
Close.
And close.
Shut down.
Oh no. So we need to start the machine. So we should see that does it really work. So you can, yeah, let's finish that in next 5 minutes. Yeah.
What
is the name? Save as
OO. Yeah. OOBE
unattended.
Yeah. Save. Everyone is in this path, right? WDS client unattended. You must be in this path. WDS, and it should open automatically this path.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Okay, so save. Everyone saved it?
Save.
Everyone saved it?
Yeah.
Except for Shahul?
Yes.
So, including Shahul? Okay. So, yes, sir. Mr. 911.
OOBE unattended client one.
Yeah.
Do you need the client one?
Just OOBE unattended.
Okay.
I mean, you can add anything, samosa, pakore, anything, right? So, yeah. Yeah, exactly. You got it. So, last step, last few steps. Yeah, I've been saying that last few steps for last half an hour. So, in the account. So now we go back to this is the final one actually. So WDS console, go to accounts, under the install images in WDS console, under the install images. This is the image we were trying to create the answer file for, right? This was the image name, right? So, install under the WDS console. Is everyone on the WDS console?
Yeah.
Everyone there, right? Then, do you see install images?
Install images, yes.
Then we click accounts.
Accounts department.
Yeah. Accounts, exactly, accounts department,
yeah.
Yes. Then do you see Windows 8.1 Enterprise Evaluation?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Everyone sees that, right?
Yes. No.
No. Inside the accounts department?
Yep.
Yes.
Yeah, I
have. You don't have an image created for the basic lab?
We have only one.
Yeah.
Only
there
one.
Should be only one basic image.
There's only one for everyone. That's just the PDF.
But well, are you in boot images or install images?
Install.
Yes, yeah,
that's it.
No, why is Pebble not able to see that?
Yes, we do.
Evaluation?
No?
Yeah.
Okay. So, right click this. Right click this. And see this. See this. You can just configure directly here now. So, when you right click, you have to go to. Let me show you this. Do you see at the end of this, when you right click and go to properties, do you see at the end of this select file?
Yes.
Select file at the end of this. Everyone sees that?
Check
the box and then select file.
Yes.
Everyone sees that?
Yes.
Yes.
Then go to, does this option open?
Yes.
Browse?
No.
Select file and
yes,
you see
there, you have to check
mark. Check mark that and then select file. Browse is there?
Yeah.
Yes.
Browse, right. Then you go to OOBE unattended, which we just created.
Yeah.
Everyone there?
Yep.
OOBE unattended?
Yep.
Just double click and click open.
Okay.
So it should look like this now.
Yes, sir.
It is looking like this for everyone. Select file should have this path.
Yes, sir.
Select file.
The browser store. Local.
Okay, let me do that quickly now.
Okay.
Apply, okay.
Yeah, so I'm just gonna quickly do that now. Install images, right click,
properties,
go down, allow image,
yes.
Select file, everyone there, right?
Yes, yes.
Yes.
Browse,
yes.
WDS unattended,
WDS unattended,
OOB unattended, that's what we created, right? OOB.
Yeah.
Okay, double click that. It should look like this.
Yes,
sir. Shall there?
Okay.
Uh oh. So press OK. And this?
Yep.
Yes.
Apply. No, this is a separate file.
Yeah.
Apply
and
OK.
Apply.
OK. Once this is done, that's it. The moment of truth.
Did it start?
No. The moment of truth is, we have to create a new virtual machine and start installation, and it should not stop at any point.
Yeah.
We are done with our server-side answer file creation.
So
how do we do that?
We don't have the machine.
And we're going to create one. So click that, and the quick one is home. Everyone on home? Create new virtual machine. Create new virtual machine. Typical. Be careful here. Typical. Next. I will install later. Everyone there?
Yeah.
I will install later. Next. Windows 8 is selected already.
Yes.
Next. Windows 8 is selected already, right?
G drive.
And then this is the second one, so I'm just going to put here WDS 3.
Okay.
Next.
Do we change the D drive now? Do we don't
yes. Well, it's going to take forever. If you change D drive or E drive, that's better.
Okay,
here, just the drive letter. Next. Yes, nothing here. Size is okay. Next.
Customize.
Customize. VMnet 14, right?
Yes.
VMnet 14 for customize screen, right?
Yes. Okay.
Everyone did that? Close.
Yes.
Start the machine.
Close. Finish.
Finish. Everyone did that?
Yes.
Shahul, did that? Finish, start the machine. So if it stops, at least the server configuration might not be implemented where it lets you just automatically go ahead without touching any screen. This option should be coming there.
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, did we put here approval? Yeah, if the approval is there, just approve it. Normally if there are 100 machines, we don't put approval, right? So server, pending device, refresh the pending device. Guys, I need to go. So, pending, approve. I think we know that step. Okay, let's go. I need to go. So, if it this.
Approved.
If it was 200 machines, we don't touch this.
Machine.
We don't touch this. If there were 200 machines, suppose, we don't touch this. It just 30 seconds it will take and automatically start. Here, we can start ourselves as well.
Automatically approved.
Right click, refresh. Okay, it started the installation. Now just good luck. It should reach the logon screen without touching anything, without stopping anywhere. So till now we only started the machine.
Thank
right?
You.
Thank you. Okay. So I'm just gonna close that and run. So if it stops at nothing other than
Hello?
Yaakob Sam, मैं आपको फोन कर रही थी आने से पहले लेकिन फोन नहीं मिल रहा था जी. असल में मेरा फोन ना बैग में था और आवाज नहीं आ रही थी. तो आप क्या गैलरी आ चुकी है? हाँ मैं आ गई हूँ. यहाँ तो गैलरी आप गैलरी आ गई हैं क्या? क्योंकि आपकी गाड़ी तो बाहर खड़ी है और नाइमा भी हमें ही है. अरे वो ना असल में सब के बाहर निकल गए. अच्छा अच्छा शायद एक गाड़ी में सब आप चले गए होंगे. चले कोई बात नहीं, मैं अपनी तस्वीर को मुकम्मल कर ली थी जब तक आप आती हैं. हाँ ठीक है आप करिए. ठीक है ओके चल अल्लाह
इतना बड़ा झूठ. अल्लाह तुझे तो झूठ भी नहीं बोला जाए.
तेरे मुंह पर आ गए तो क्या होगा?
क्या होगा?
नहीं यार तो झूठ बोला बहुत मुश्किल है.
तुम कोई झूठ नहीं है.
करियर पे फोकस करना चाहूंगी और सेफ उस तरह करेगा तो तू क्या करेगा?
लेकिन बच्ची